So this project is called the Shiva Museum. It is being developed by the Amber Development Authority in Jaipur on a small plot of 4,000 square meters. Their idea was to create a museum for Lord Shiva. If you look at museums all across the world, museums are something that come on 4 acres and 5 acres and 6 acres and 10 acres and even more than that pieces of land. Whereas this land is 1 acre. It's a tiny wedge-shaped plot just touching a main road, but a very interesting site nevertheless. So this site is about 4,000 square meters only. It's just an acre and it's like a wedge like this at the road junction. And the main road goes by like this from here. Now the interesting thing in this site is that if you go slightly high, you get a view of the Mansarovar Lake and you get that whole pavilion which is in the middle, which is Jal Mahal. Very, very popular for marriages, and it's an old heritage structure and you can see it floating in the water, literally. The other very important thing in this site is that there is an existing temple here. So first when we got this project, the first thing we did is went and spent a few hours on this site, just to understand what it, you know, reference to context, reference to location. When you go up, that's the view, fantastic view on this side towards the lake. And here you see this temple. Now, then we spent some time and did a study as to how people are actually using this place. Now, this is the temple. You would expect that people would come from the road, but as is the case in India everywhere, people like to take shortcuts. So they actually currently take a shortcut through this plot. So if you see movement pattern, people are moving. There's less number coming like this, but there's more number going this way. And we actually did this whole study pattern. Now we had to design about 75,000 square feet as a museum. So our first thing was that people move like this. Let's not disturb this. Let's do something where the building we make here and the building we make here in two parts. But then actually it's one museum. So how does one tackle that? And it's not a very large museum. So we said this will become a whole pedestrian plaza spine kind of thing. And then to make it interesting, we put steps here. So this actually goes up to first floor. Now, normally when you see any structure, you see the whole thing. The moment you put steps, you start seeing less. So then what happens, the vision comes only to this top part of the temple, which has got these nice chhatris on top. So your focus literally now from the road, because you stepped up this whole pedestrian pathway, is you're focusing on just this chhatri. So the chhatri is getting framed in between this building mass. And then as you climb the steps, this whole temple comes into view. So that is one thing. So it makes the whole path and the way this temple is seen very interesting. Number two, it keeps the whole pedestrian movement as it was. Number three, this becomes like a translation of the internal Indian courtyard, which is there in all traditional architecture to reduce heat. There is also this aspect that in India, we don't provide public spaces. The government is not doing enough. So as architects, whenever you get the choice, although one would do it on a much larger project, but even a small 40,000 square feet plot, you can still create a public space. So let's say somebody does not want to go to the museum. They can still come here, they can sit on these steps, there can be a performance happening here with this temple at the backdrop, and people are sitting here and watching this. The same way we thought that it's very important, because the moment you go high, you see this whole lake. So it's very important that even this becomes a very important public space. So therefore, we've created an access from here, which is a vertical circulation spine, which takes you straight on top. So let's say you don't want to go to the museum. People of the city can still use all of this space. They can still go up and then use this whole terrace, which is a landscape terrace on top. So these are some of the parameters. And then what we've done is that now, since this is divided, we've actually created a program for the Shiva Museum. So Shiva has 108 names. So the first thing you do is you enter this hall and it's got all the 108 names and what they mean. So it's the name part of the museum. Then you cut across this pedestrian spine and you have a different segment, so the whole Shiva history is there. Then you go at the upper level, and then there's a bridge that takes you across. And then again there's a bridge that again takes you across to the next level. So at every level there are these connecting bridges. So the whole, you know, experience becomes very interesting, because I've seen that, you know, when people go to museums, they are in that enclosed space for a pretty long time. So he said, why don't you give the person a break each time? So you finish one segment, you get a break because you're coming out through this bridge, you're seeing people below, you're seeing some activity, and plus this is naturally ventilated and not air-conditioned space. Then you go back into an enclosure. You see this portion, again you have a break, you come back and you see the next level above. So it becomes a very, very interesting transitional space, and this is the focus of this design. Now, if you look at Jaipur, in Jaipur, if you sit in a car, 15 minutes you drive in any direction, you will pass a traditional structure in Jaipur. And then unfortunately, in the last 10 years, the kind of buildings people have made are all wraparound curtain walled glass buildings, which do not suit Rajasthan. And forget not suiting Rajasthan in terms of look. It does not suit Rajasthan in terms of energy efficiency. This is a place with 40 degrees Celsius for 8 months of the year. You cannot put glass on a building. So we've looked at this project not just to make a museum, at several aspects. There is a whole, you know, tribe of people who've been used to working in stone, creating stone jalis, using stone walls, and these are families that have, you know, from generations passed it down. And now suddenly they're all out of work, because everybody is making things in GRC, other materials which are much easier and much more economical. So our idea is to revive that traditional art, and the entire building is proposed in local sandstone, which will be done by the artisans. And even these are all solid walls, and then there are perforations where it moves inside, and you have like these court sheltered spaces. So even within the museum spaces, there are these sheltered outdoor spaces where people can walk out and sit in isolation or just have a small group. And then this entire wall is also like a huge parametric design created in those stone jalis, which are reminiscent of traditional architecture, so that there is a throwback on tradition. You're always going open, enclosed, open, enclosed. You're walking through this spine courtyard which runs through the building. You have respected the existing conditions of the site and left the pathway to the temple. So while it's a small project, it takes cognizance of all these factors that make it a contextual design solution for its location, and at the same time reviving the stone art which is very prevalent in Rajasthan.